CNET's videos on WordPress. Today I'll be showing you how to install WordPress to your blog or website. Installing WordPress is a very simple process. It only takes a couple of minutes, and so I'm going to take you through the process and show you how easy it can be done. First, what we're going to do is open up an internet browser. From here, we're going to want to go to WordPress.org. Once we're on WordPress.org, we'll notice that there's a Download WordPress tab, and there's also a Download section up at the top too. Either one you can click on. And then we want to go ahead and download the actual file for WordPress. You're going to be asked if you'd like to save or open it. You're going to want to save it. And for convenience sake, I'm just going to save it right to our desktop because we're going to be needing it in just a moment. Okay, and once WordPress is done downloading, you'll notice that there's a WordPress zip file on your desktop. Go ahead and open up that. Within the zip file, you'll notice there's a WordPress folder. Go ahead and drag that to your desktop. Should only take a second. Okay, and in this folder is basically our WordPress core files, all the configuration, the styles, and all that stuff. It's all within this file right here. So the next step is to take this file and put it on our actual website. A good way of doing this is to log into an FTP client and just go ahead and transfer everything over. I'm going to use a FTP program called FileZilla. You can obtain FileZilla free, and all you gotta do is do a Google search for FileZilla. It should be the first thing that shows up. So next, what we want to do is go ahead and log into our website. To do that, you're going to enter in your database host right here, the username to access it, and the password, and connect. From here, you'll notice on the right side is our site directory, and on the left side is our local computer directory. We want to go ahead and navigate to where our website is contained. And for this purpose, I'm going to be doing a demo. So once we have that folder open up, what we want to do is literally take this WordPress file and copy it over. But before we want to do that, there's one thing we want to change within the WordPress file system. So once we open up our WordPress folder, we'll notice that there is a WP config sample file. What we want to do with this is actually edit it. And to edit it, all we got to do is just open it up. And in here, it actually asks for our database information. So up at the top is where our database name is going to go. The username for your database is going to go right here, the password to log into it, and the local host of your SQL database. Once you get all that stuff in there, you're good to go and transferring it. You can go ahead and rename this WP config and then begin your transfer. I'm going to go ahead and use a pre-configured WordPress config and replace that. And from here, all we have to do is take all the files in our WordPress folder and copy them over. And you'll notice down here that there's some transferrings going on. And this is going to take a little while, so I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead. Okay, and once we have all of our WordPress files transfer over to our website, we can go ahead and close out of FileZilla. And we can go ahead and close all of our WordPress folder as well. Next, what we want to do is open back up an internet browser. And up here, we're going to go ahead and log into our domain. So, for example, mine is okay, and once everything is transferred over, you can now log into the WordPress backend of things. And the WordPress backend looks very similar to this. Right up here, we can choose a site title. So on the main, let's see that. Here you can choose your administrator name to log into your WordPress backend. Down here, you're going to enter in a password twice. attach an email to this as well. And another thing that you want to also make sure is checked. It's checked by default, but if you want to disable or enable searchability of your blog or website, this is where you can go ahead and click or unclick that, and it'll take you off Google directory. But once everything is set up, all we have to do is click on the button to install WordPress to finish up our process. And in a few seconds, you should get a message indicating success and that WordPress has been installed. Once we're done here, we can go ahead and log in. You'll be taken to the WordPress login screen. This is what it's going to look like every time you log into WordPress. This is also customizable, and we can cover that in a later video. But once we log into WordPress, we're taken to the dashboard, and if everything successfully installed, should be good to go from here. Alright, this concludes the installation of WordPress. Please stay tuned for more videos on WordPress.